Welcome back. In this video, I wanted to talk about my experience preparing for the commercial pilot's license. And so starting last summer of 2021, I started working with one of my instructors at Camarillo Flight Instruction, and I began working towards my commercial single engine pilot license. And one of the reasons I wanted to get the commercial single pilot license for me is because I do fly for work, and being able to get around means that you have to really be able to rely on yourself to have the skills to make the right judgment and have the right technique to fly from place to place, so I can get to hospitals and clinics that I work at in the Southern California area. And so the reason to get the commercial was, one, for insurance purposes, to lower my insurance premium and to make overall my safety be higher in flying. And so I began working with Riley, my instructor at Camarillo Flight Instruction. And we started in the summer of 21, and we're able to do a couple of cross countries. One needs to be a 2-hour day cross country, and one needs to be a 2-hour night cross country that's greater than 100 nautical miles. And so planned a cross country that was exactly more than 100 nautical miles. And once we completed that and started working towards the commercial maneuvers. And the commercial maneuvers are several kind of continuous movement maneuvers where you make constant input changes to the flight controls, chandelles, lazy eights, eights on pylons, accelerated stall. So these are some maneuvers that you need to be able to do. And probably the most difficult one by far is power off 180, which is simulated engine failure in the traffic pattern as you're about to land. And so your instructor pulls the power, and you have to pick a spot on the runway and land it, gliding the airplane with no added thrust or not putting the power back in. And so over about 6 months, I began preparing for this checkride, and I flew with three different instructors at different flying schools as I was working in different parts of the country. And as I got closer to being ready to schedule the check ride, I picked a day, talked to my instructor. He did the written endorsement for the check ride. And we scheduled initially December 9th of 2021 to do the commercial single check ride. Well, as luck would have it, it was raining that day. And so there was no way we were going to be able to do the flying portion of the exam. So we went ahead and rescheduled it for January 23rd. So almost, 40, 50 days later, because I was just busy around this time. I was working a lot, had a lot of surgeries scheduled, and could not find an open day before that. So on the day of the check ride, I filled out my IACRA on the FAA website. I got the airworthiness documents prepared. I plan to take the check ride in a Cessna 172. And the reason for that is because you do not need to take the commercial check ride in a complex airplane. It doesn't need to have retractable gear. It doesn't need to have a constant speed prop. It can be a fairly simple airplane like a Cessna 172. And Cessna 172 also has a very good predictable kind of glide ratio when you do the power off 180. And it's a utility category airplane, which means that it has a stronger airframe and it can withstand higher G loading. And that's what you want when you're doing some of these maneuvers that put strain on the airframe. And so I scheduled it for January 23rd. On the day of the check ride, weather was good, severe clear. I spent about 2 hours doing the oral portion of the exam, and that went well. Went on to so what we talked about during the oral portion, we talked about risk management, I'd say was the theme, talking about how we planned a cross country that was planned in advance. It was a day VFR cross country from Camarillo to Napa, and then a night VFR cross country from Napa to South Lake Tahoe. And I think the challenging part about planning that check ride is planning a night VFR check ride into a mountainous area such as Lake Tahoe. And so without revealing too much from the check ride, I just want to say that I think that is a true test of a pilot's judgment, is whether or not you should go to a mountainous area that has high altitude. And for a number of reasons, I think only with a very high performing aircraft would you want to go night VFR into Lake Tahoe. And so we went on to the flying portion, did the flying maneuvers. So left Camarillo, did a few different kinds of takeoffs and landings at Camarillo, then did some of these maneuvers. We did the eights on pylons kind of over a mountain, which I'd never really practiced them like that, but was able to execute the maneuver. And then went into the traffic pattern at Oxnard. I did some of the landings and then came back to Camarillo. And the end result was that I passed the commercial single check ride. And I want to give credit to the flight instructors that helped to instruct me along the way. And I would say since 2009 up until today, I've flown with over a dozen flight instructors. And as part of the logbook entries for this commercial check ride, I reached out to my flight instructors from Texas that I hadn't flown with in 10 years and let them know that I was taking the check ride. And all around, I received, you know, unanimous support and mentorship and help along the way. And this was a goal of mine for a long time. And I feel honored to say that I'm a commercial pilot. And if you are getting ready to take a check ride, even for private pilot, feel free to comment below, reach out, and I'd be happy to give you my two cents of advice. You know, take it with a grain of salt. I'm not a certified flight instructor, but I want to encourage anyone to you know, pursue their goals and, you know, stop dreaming and just start flying. It's a lifelong hobby, and it's very rewarding, and flying's been really good for my family and my friends. And I think that if you ever considered getting a pilot's license, don't hesitate.